Welcome to the Victorious Life TV broadcast. I'm Lisa Buldo, and if you've been looking to shed those pounds, right? We've got a really special treat for you tonight, and we're talking about health, but weight loss in particular. And joining us tonight is no stranger to the Victorious Life. We've got best-selling author, certified biblical health coach, owner of Heaven and Earth Healing Center, and my good friend, Tonijean Kulpinski, joining us tonight. Welcome, Tonijean.
Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you for taking the time out of your super busy schedule to be with us tonight. And I know that our viewers love you, and they've been waiting for you. So yay. Say hi to Tonijean in the comments. So wonderful.
Thank you.
So it's always wonderful when you can be with us. Yay, right?
My pleasure.
So Tonijean is the author of the best-selling book, Stop Battling Disease and Start Building Wellness. And, you know, in addition, she's got another brand new book that's coming out soon, very soon, and then we'll have to have you back again, only this time it's going to be a cookbook with fabulous recipes. So we'll talk more about that later.
I'm excited.
Yay, right? So we're going to dive right in tonight, and because I know you know, we're going to have a lot to say on this broadcast, and it's really going to be a blessing to you. So Tonijean, first of all,
Yes. You
have a super powerful testimony, and you can let the viewers know. Tell us what happened to you
Yes. And
why you are so extremely passionate about health and helping others now.
Well, first and foremost, I've been on this journey almost 11 years, and I can honestly say I learned the message of health the hard way. Yeah. I yo-yo dieted from the age of 16 years old because I believed I had a weight issue. But that was a lie, because if I focused on eating foods in the form God created, I didn't know that, but my body could get into balance. But I suffered from numerous health issues, from losing weight and gaining weight and losing weight and gaining weight from a very young age. And I caused a lot of health problems, severe bone loss of my skeletal structure, dental problems, digestive disorders, thyroid issues, skin problems, panic attacks, blood glucose intolerance. And there was a time in my life where I actually lost too much weight, and I became very unhealthy and couldn't gain weight in a healthy way. And I remember calling out to God and just asking him to show me a way, and he led me to scripture, and I started incorporating biblical guidelines on how to heal and restore my health. And right from the very start, I started repairing my body, and now at the age of 48, I never suffer from any of those health issues any longer, but I do maintain a healthy weight because there wasn't anything wrong with me. God makes us perfect, but sometimes we listen to the media and different avenues of health, but we have to go back to scripture and really learn how to incorporate what God created for food to create balance and health in our bodies.
Praise God. You know, so many people are battling with sickness and disease, and you just covered a lot of different conditions that even, you know, come. I mean, you said that you yo-yo, you know, you were up and down and gaining weight and losing weight. And as a result of all of that, there was like this vicious cycle that was happening, resulting in all this other stuff. Why do you think so many people struggle with weight loss in particular?
Yes.
Or to get those pounds off?
I believe that one of the number one reasons, because I was a victim of this, there's a lot of information out there in the media. And I believe that more than half of it is wrong.
Wow.
And I was one of those people that embarked on every dietary theory that was out there because I was so desperate to wear a smaller size. And so I tried everything. And I think a lot of the viewers may be subject to that as well, and trying all these different types of diets, because people are looking to lose weight. They're not worried or thinking about, I have to get healthy first, get the body into balance, and the weight's going to come off effortlessly. But no, we're in a big rush to wear the latest fashions and the latest sizes, but we're not really focusing on long-term health. So I think that's one of the biggest problems with going on these fad diets that are actually impacting our health in a very serious way. So going back to nature and eating real food is what we really have to do, so the body becomes healthy and in balance.
I love what you said, Tonijean, you know, when you said that you have to stop looking at it as I have to lose weight versus I have to start eating healthy. That is huge. I mean, my gosh, if people could just remember that, right? And, you know, if you think about healthy food, foods without labels, That's right.
Absolutely, directly from nature.
Directly
out
from nature.
Out of a box, not prepackaged, not having a shelf life, not something that has to be artificially, with artificial ingredients to extend the shelf life, because this is what's going to harm us.
Yes.
So we have to eat directly from nature.
Right, your body would see all that artificial stuff is foreign, right?
Correct.
And then that can cause more trouble.
Can cause allergies, can cause digestive issues, because the body can't recognize it, so the body cannot digest and assimilate it properly. So you become intolerant to those foods. We want to eat real whole foods that are not in a box, that are not prepackaged, that are not refined, that your body really knows how to utilize and assimilate properly. It's all about getting the body into balance and homeostasis to keep the body healthy.
What are some of, I know you covered some that you went through, but what are some other health conditions that are associated with being overweight?
I would say heart disease, number one above all, having too much inflammation around the heart, the myocardial valve, joint problems, knee problems. A lot of people have issues with their weight, so they're suffering from joint problems because there's too much weight on the skeletal structure, bone loss, severe digestive disorders, diabetes or blood glucose intolerance. It could be hypoglycemia. Thyroid issues.
Yeah.
So there's a numerous amount of health issues that can really be affecting us from being overweight.
Wow. Yeah, we got to bring the body back into balance.
Yes.
So, you know, you touched on this before. There's so much conflicting information out there, right? Between the fad diets, what's right, what's wrong. You know, every expert has a different opinion. But what I love about you, what I love about Tonijean is that she goes back to the biblical perspective, what God intended for food, right?
Amen.
So nutritionally speaking, and I know you touched on some of this, but what should we be eating for health, to be healthy, to lose that weight?
Well, so one of the biggest problems with the many dietary theories that are out there is we're excluding fruits and vegetables.
Mm.
We're not eating enough fiber. We're so protein, we're worried that we're not getting enough protein.
Yeah.
But I just want to elaborate on that for a minute.
Please.
Any kind of a diet, you're going to lose weight. Whenever you are lessening your caloric intake, of course weight is going to come off, but that's not success.
Right.
That's just a fad, and it's not long-term. It's not healthy. So I do realize that the keto diet is running around the globe big time nowadays.
Yeah.
But there's a major problem with it. We're eating too much protein and not enough fiber and carbohydrates. The body runs on carbohydrates. The body runs on glucose in the form of fruits and vegetables. And we're excluding that, or we're not eating enough of them. We have a fruit fear because people are afraid of the sugar. But this sugar differs very much from sugar in the sugar bowl, which we definitely want to exclude. So we have to be eating more fruits specifically because there's polysaccharides in fruit and they actually help the body speed up the metabolism. So you're satiated longer and the weight comes off effortlessly. You're satisfied because you're dealing with a lot of minerals. A lot of people have a lot of mineral loss.
Mineral deficiencies.
Mineral deficiencies,
yeah.
Exactly. So when you're incorporating more fruits and vegetables, you're definitely going to stay hydrated. The cells are going to be hydrated. Where the keto diet, your cells actually can become, you can suffer from dehydration of the cells, where you can develop a symptom called ketoacidosis eating too much meat protein or even too many nuts and too many seeds, because there is also vegan keto that can be very dangerous because we're afraid to add the fruit. Fruit is amazing. I personally reverse pre-diabetes from eating a lot of fruit.
Very
people
good.
Are in shock of that. So protein is in everything, so we don't have to be worried about not getting enough protein in our diet because it's the building blocks of everything.
Someone was just telling me the other day that she's been on the keto diet for so long and she has hair loss.
Yes.
And
yes.
So, I mean, my goodness, these fads, you have to go back to what God says,
Amen.
Right? Intended for. So what are some of the foods to avoid, Tonijean?
Well, I would say, of course, processed foods, but let me elaborate on that for a moment. Whole wheat pastas, whole wheat breads, these are not good for us. They cause inflammation of our joints, inflammation of the receptor sites of our cells. A lot of people think, oh, I need to do everything whole wheat now. Nope, I happen to love pasta, and I eat a lot of pasta, but I use the bean pastas. And if I am going to eat any source of wheat, it's ancient wheat in small quantities like kamut or spelt, or einkorn. We don't want to eat any modern wheat or semolina or bleached wheats, because this is also going to cause, you know, not only weight gain, it's going to pack on the weight very quickly, but it's going to cause a lot of inflammation in the body because your body can't assimilate it or break it down. So you're going to gain weight easily.
So even the regular pasta, like the semolina, the other regular white pastas,
this is a no-no.
Yeah.
Now, I don't want to disappoint the viewers too much. If you want to have it once in a while,
small
amounts, if you really have to have it, but the lentil pastas, the bean pastas,
like
the brown rice pastas, I cook a lot of this myself, they do really well. They work very well with all types of sauces and dishes. So,
can you touch on artificial sweeteners? Because I know that's a big subject for a lot of people.
Yes, absolutely. Yes. I can. Just the word artificial should really put a red flag up for us.
Yes.
So artificial sweeteners like Splenda, this doesn't come from sugar, Sweet and Low, Equal, any of these sweeteners have a major impact on the brain and nervous system. Number one, they're heavy metals, so they can actually calcify in our brain, leading to brain loss or memory loss or even Parkinson's disease or Alzheimer's. Very, very dangerous form of heavy metal that can actually impact the liver being the filtration system. So it also tricks our body into thinking that we're hungry, so we'll eat more than we should. So this is not a good choice. But some good sweeteners would be raw honey. Raw honey is one of my favorite. Raw honey is antimicrobial. It's very similar to a multivitamin because it has everything you need in it. Raw honey can actually help you lose weight because of the vitamin and mineral content. There's mineral deficiencies that make us crave. So raw honey can actually help subside those cravings. Maple syrup is great for purifying the liver. Remember, you want to keep your liver clean. Keeping the body internally clean is a great way to build wellness and keep the body at a healthy weight. So maple syrup is another great way. If you're looking for a granulated sweetener, coconut sugar is really well, or works really well in baking and cooking. So those would be my top three of choices.
Very good. Mm-hmm. Very good. Now, we also know about staying hydrated, right? Now, this is something we've heard forever.
Yes.
Drink your water. Make sure that you get enough water. Why is hydration so important? Well, I mean, it's kind of, we're made up mostly of water, but how much water should, you know, do you recommend that we drink on a daily basis?
We may be hearing a lot of it, but that's a great question because people aren't staying hydrated.
That's true.
First and foremost, it's you know, even in the cooler months, we still want to stay hydrated because probably even more so because you're indoors more, so you have the heat on.
Mm-hmm.
So it's very easy to get dehydrated, wake up with a dry throat. This is a sign of dehydration. Why is water so important and how much? One, water transports nutrients from our food into our cells. Plus, it also exports toxins out of the body, out of the liver, out of the cells, which can inhibit good health. So we really need to enhance our health, not inhibit. So water is so critical every single day. Now, when you do increase more fruits and vegetables, remember, those foods are naturally hydration.
Yay.
So eating more, you are going to stay hydrated. So on an average, I would say about 8 to 10 glasses of water every day for the average person. I also believe in fresh raw juicing because this also keeps the body in balance and homeostasis rather than in ketosis.
Mm-hmm.
And it will also hydrate the cells. So a combination of these types of liquids are fantastic. But water, I would say about 8 to 10 cups.
Of 8 ounces. Right. Very good.
Per day, per person.
Very good. And okay, so I know that another thing that people are very concerned about is cholesterol levels.
Oh, yes. Yes.
So what are some natural ways to improve not only cholesterol levels, but the triglycerides, right? The fats in the blood.
Mm-hmm.
Talk to us about that.
Okay, so that's another great question. So first of all, I do want to say what cholesterol is, because everybody is in sheer terror of the word cholesterol. I gotta lower it. Well, first understand what cholesterol is. The liver, I believe, is one of the most important organs because it is our filtration system. Just like when a swimming pool has a filter, you have to keep it clean so the water is not polluted. So your liver has to be kept clean so the blood doesn't become diseased or disconnection of ease. So when you think about the liver, it manufactures a substance called cholesterol. cholesterol is actually a repair substance. So if there's a lot of inflammation in the body, because it's also an inflammatory marker, if there's a lot of inflammation, then your repair substance known as cholesterol is going to elevate. We don't want to artificially lower it with a drug,
right?
Because then the body is not doing it correctly and you're still going to remain with the problem. So one of the best ways to reduce triglycerides, now think of the word glyceride. That's sugar.
Sugar
from the sugar bowl. So it's not always fat that's the problem, because there's some really good fats out there and there's some really bad fats, like the trans fatties, like canola and soy, hydrogenated oils. We definitely want to stay away from them. But believe it or not, by increasing fruit sugars, green leafy vegetables, avocados, raw nuts and seeds in the right quantities, healthy oils like coconut oil and olive oil and flaxseed oil and hemp seed oil will actually reduce the inflammation in the body and the need for elevated cholesterol levels. So cholesterol is our friend. It is certainly not our enemy,
right?
But we need to reduce it naturally by incorporating real whole food nutrition, staying hydrated, and then your cholesterol will go down naturally and not artificially and being forced by a statin or a cholesterol lowering drug. So actually eat to live, so we don't need the need for excess amounts of cholesterol.
Boy, very good. We need a day.
We could talk about cholesterol all day.
Or just health, right? It's wonderful. Very, very pertinent and important information right there. I love what you said about the triglycerides, like sugar, right? Like a lot of times it's from sugar. When people have a fatty liver, right?
Yes.
Even a skinny person or a thin person or someone who's not overweight can be dealing with that.
So a lot of people have fatty liver disease and they can be very thin,
yeah.
And that doesn't really mean anything.
Mm.
So yes.
Now let's talk about stress and how that affects weight loss. Why is stress dangerous? And what are some things that people can do? Because we know in this fast-paced, people are grab and go, and so they're eating, you know, probably not the best foods, the processed foods, and they're stressed out on top of it.
Yes.
Well,
we all know how poor our health suffers or how we feel when we're under a tremendous amount of stress. We're all under stress, Lisa, but how do we manage the stress is really the key component in reducing stress. So I'm going to say the number one thing to help reduce stress, my favorite is prayer, because I believe that we get a lot of peace. I get a lot of peace, and I know you do too, or that you would. Praying to God, the Almighty Physician, I get tremendous peace. When I'm in a stressful situation, I reach out and I call out to the Lord, and He immediately calms my heart and gives me peace and assurance and reassurance. So I automatically start feeling better. And I know that God, the great I am, is going to take care of my situation. So that would be number one of all. Second would be another one of my favorites, and that's massage therapy, foot reflexology. Yeah. It calms me. And I know that a lot of my patients feel the same. It helps stimulate endorphins in the body, because also pain can cause stress in the body.
Yeah.
So our natural painkillers known as endorphins, massage therapy helps straighten that out and get you to feel better, to reduce pain, to reduce inflammation, even emotional pain.
Yes.
Exercise is really important. So
good. I'm glad you're touching on that too.
Exercise is critical.
Hand
in hand. You're not feeling good, you just want to get outside, and if it's too cold, you can get a rebounder or a mini trampoline.
That's what I have.
Good for you.
Or
an exercise bike and start. So this also helps because it reduces cortisol levels.
Mm-hmm.
It balances the hormones. So exercise is really important.
So important. And especially, you know, as we age, and a lot of times people say, I'm too tired to exercise, but exercise is what gives you energy. Right? You know, God showed me a while ago, Tonijean, this was in the early morning hours. You know, I was kind of just thinking, I know I need to be exercising more. And the Lord showed me, He said, think about this, think on this. He said, pay attention to the way people move, right? How they walk, people who exercise and people who don't.
Wow.
Well, and He was showing me how when you are moving your body, you're exercising, you're going to have more energy. You're going to have that spring in your step, right? You're going to just, you're going to be stronger and you're going to be more flexible, right? And then you're not going to be so prone to having a fall as so many do, and then because your core will be strong. But I love what you said, prayer. Now, you guys who watch my broadcast, you know, don't get me started.
You
know, I'm like,
get started.
Yeah, right? But I'm just saying, you speak to your mountain, you Amen. Believe, you receive, and I heard yes. faith in yes. what you were talking about.
Yes.
Because you said, and I know that God will help me and show me the way. That's faith.
Amen.
Praise God.
Absolutely.
Come on, girl. Woo! Yay! So, Tonijean, I know that you have helped countless of people. Her, the stories on, you know, her website, and I know you personally, but I mean, my gosh, the testimonials from people, how they've reversed their health. I mean, I've seen people with like the worst skin conditions, like the before and afters, and even like in Tonijean's first book, this book, well, oh my gosh, if you haven't picked up this book yet, I just want to say, make sure that you jump on Amazon and get it. It's called Stop Battling Disease and Start Building Wellness by Tonijean Kulpinski. And you could just Google Stop Battling Disease and Start Building Wellness and it will come right up. She is a best-selling author. This book went to number one like immediately on Amazon. I mean, my goodness, it is all God. But you know what I'm saying? But you do the work, Tonijean. You have a passion. She loves people. That's why I love her, you know, because I do. She loves people. She has a heart for the Lord.
Amen.
And she knows that everything that you've talked about, all the food, all the nutrition, it's God's way.
Amen. And we have to be obedient
to
that.
And we have to be obedient.
He doesn't want our bodies to be sick. We're not meant to be sick. Age is not a prerequisite to disease. We were created in God's image, not man's image.
So with that, do you have a recent weight loss success story that you can share with us? I'm sure you have many,
yes, well,
but maybe just one or two.
I have many stories of different variations of health issues, people recovering fully. But I first want to say that I don't personally cure anyone.
Right.
I am a vessel. I am a transmitter of this information. And I give the Lord, the Holy Spirit, all the glory.
Woo!
Always, always.
Yes, we do.
Because I am obedient to what he asked me to do. He healed me of various health conditions.
Yes.
Yo-yo dieting, cancer, you know.
We didn't even talk about that.
We didn't even talk about that yet. It's in here.
Yeah.
But the point is that, you know, the Lord restored my health, but I was obedient and listened to what he told me to do. He told me to stop listening to the media, stop listening to everything else that you're hearing, and follow my word.
Right.
So, and that's what I did, and that's why I'm so passionate about this. And my passion led me to the clients and the patients that he sent to me. And I have one woman in particular, her name is Michelle Seferi, and she is actually in my second book. Her recipe is in my second book, her delicious and amazing brownie recipe and her testimony. Mm-hmm. And I believe she's watching this evening. Michelle came to me a few years ago with over 100 pounds to lose.
Wow.
And she canceled her weight loss surgery. She lost over 100 pounds, but Michelle suffered because some of the health conditions when you're overweight and toxic can be, which is what she had. She was on thyroid medication. She was on a breathing machine.
Mm.
She couldn't walk very well. She had pain throughout her body constantly, which disabled her from walking well. This was a young woman in her early 50s who had her whole life ahead of her.
Yeah.
She had high blood pressure and was on high blood pressure medication. And she did not have her weight loss surgery, followed these biblical principles that I incorporate in my practice. And Michelle was a complete success story, and we are very good friends today because of it.
So how much weight did she lose?
100 pounds. She lost 100 pounds. So praise God. We give him all the glory. And we praise Michelle for being obedient and being diligent. It's diligence. This isn't magic.
See,
this is work.
And here's the thing. Your faith pulls like gravity and will make you well. But here's the thing. The Holy Spirit, he is our comforter.
Amen.
He is our guide. He teaches you. And he, listen, the Lord gave you your physical body. And I say this all the time, and many times the Holy Spirit will show you what you need to do or change or eat to nourish your physical body.
Amen.
So that it can come into health. So what you're saying is beautiful. It's exactly right. And so, but thank God for the vessel that you are in helping so many people. Now, Tonijean knows, she's been through it. This is not someone who just did research and hasn't been through it herself.
Amen.
Like, you know, and she has seen God
Amen.
Answer. Boom. Prayer after prayer after prayer. But
may
she knows. Do you believe? Yes, please.
I want to say that woman, Michelle, is off all her medications. I just want to say that. She's off all her medications. But I also want to address that
although I've gone to school, because you just hit on a very important topic, and I want the viewers to understand, although I've gone to nutrition school, different nutrition schools, I have certifications and degrees that are hanging on the wall of my practice, and I'm proud of that. I worked hard.
Yeah.
But I believe my greatest credential is my personal journey, how I went from very sick to extraordinarily healthy and stayed that way.
Wow.
I don't have bad days and good days. I have great days with my health each and every day of my life. And that is the fire that God has ignited in me to pass on to you. And I also want to add one other thing. I do not believe in recycled information. I do not believe in, I get it firsthand raw from God because I listen to the voice of the Lord.
Amen.
I hear that still small voice and I listen. And we have to listen because he's speaking to us every single day. The Spirit of God lives and dwells in us. And we need to listen because it's there. And I do not believe on a scientific study based on another scientific study because science and research, I'm sorry.
The wisdom of man.
Is right. Just, and you know, medical care is important for emergency care, but there's no health care in the system. And I believe that real true nutritional healing comes from above.
Amen.
And his name is Jesus Christ.
Woo!
And I do believe in the power. I believe in it because I'm living proof. I was near death, literally.
Yeah.
I had no quality of life. I suffered from migraines every day. I never felt good. And I'm on this journey 11 years plus, and I live healthy and vibrant every day pushing 50. And I feel like a healthy 16-year-old. And that's why I'm
beautiful.
So passionate, because it breaks my heart
to see people
not
I know.
Well.
I hate it too.
And God is the foundation
it.
Of it all.
Amen. Tonijean, we only have a couple minutes left, but I know that you do consultations for people.
Yes.
And it doesn't matter where you are, because she does phone consultations as well as in person. And she also speaks to groups and different organizations. Mm-hmm. So where is the best place for someone to contact you?
Okay, well, first and foremost, you can go to my website, which is stopbattlingdisease.com, part of the name of my book. So once again, that's stopbattlingdisease.com.
Maybe someone can type it in the comments. That would be great. StopBattlingDisease.com.
And you can reach my office, and I do telephone appointments, just like Lisa said. I have lots of patients around the globe that I've never actually met in person. And I also obviously have local patients that come in to my office for private nutritional counseling. And I teach those patients how to build wellness, because we have to stop battling and start building.
Yes.
The battle was 1,000s of years ago,
yes.
So why are we battling?
We already
are cured, hallelujah, right?
Right. Jesus already paid the price for
absolutely.
Your healing. You know what? We're gonna close the broadcast, but make sure that you share this broadcast with everyone that you can on your social media. Let people know about Tonijean. Make sure that you go on Amazon.com, pick up the book. And if you go to Amazon.com, you could type in Stop Battling Disease and Start Building Wellness, the name of the book, and you know it will come right up. And like I said, I'm sure it's got a lot of great reviews as well. I remember, I need a review
too.
Yes, you do. I do. I'm sorry I haven't. But I know firsthand it is amazing, because this is my book. And this is a go-to when I need to know something. And of course, she's got your next cookbook is coming out really soon, and then we'll have to have her on the broadcast again.
Thank you.
So, I just wanted to say, you know, make sure that you share this video. Again, visit Tonijean's website at Stop Battling Disease and to stopbattlingdisease.com. I was about to say the name of your book again.
That's perfect.
It's been such an honor to have you with us tonight, and
I just
want to end with prayer. Mm-hmm. So, Lord, we just thank you right now. We thank you for Tonijean, Lord. We thank you for her heart. We thank you for the viewer watching. And if you are battling with any sickness, any disease, in Jesus' name, I say, be healed and be made whole right now. We thank you, Holy Spirit, that you speak to each and every one, and you tell us if there's anything that we need to do on our end. And Lord, instinctively, we know. And I just thank you right now. And if you've never made Jesus the Lord of your life, and you can do that right now, just say, Lord Jesus, and mean it with your whole heart. Lord Jesus, come into my heart right now. Teach me your ways. Take my life and make it what you want it to be. I am sorry for my sins, and I ask you to be my Lord and Savior. Thank you, Jesus. Amen and amen. Welcome to the family of God.
Amen.
Well, we are out of time, but thank you so much for watching. I know this has been a blessing to you tonight. Tonijean, thank you for
thank you so
all
much.
Of the amazing and incredible, very credible information.
Thank you back as
you
well.
You're amazing.
For your amazing information.
Oh, I just adore you, Lisa.
Thank you.
All right, and thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time on The Victorious Life. Good night.